Hey guys, Mike Henry here, and we're talking about the Rheem hybrid heat pump water heater. Today's video is going to be centered around room air requirements. So let's talk about room air requirements for just a minute. Now we all know that standard electric water heaters don't really have any air requirements, but since this is a combination of an electric water heater and a heat pump or a hybrid, room air is something that needs to be taken into consideration. So what is a heat pump? Well, in short, it's a system that extracts heat from the air around it, transfers that heat to a refrigerant system, which then compresses that refrigerant to superheat it, and then uses that superheated refrigerant to heat the steel tank, and in turn, the water inside of it. Although it takes much longer to heat the water this way, as opposed to the traditional way of using electricity to energize heating elements, it's a much more efficient way. About four times more efficient. Now, setting aside how the water gets heated, one of the byproducts of this heat pump's operating process is cooler, drier air. Of course, that's not a bad thing. In another video, we'll talk about not only what we can do with that cool, dry air, we'll also talk about where we can access a good source of the warm, moist air needed for this heater to operate most efficiently. Now, back to those room air requirements. As you can imagine, there's a certain amount of air needed for this heater to go through a heating cycle. We'll get into the specifics of it in just a minute, but a few things before we do. Obviously, the warmer and more humid the air is, the better, because it's easier to extract heat from humid air than it is from drier air. Going through a heating cycle will eventually produce more cool, dry air, and at the same time, leave less warm, moist air. That's the reason we need a certain amount of air to work with. Otherwise, we'd end up with air that's too cool and dry, and our efficiency would begin to go down. One option to not having enough air in the room that the heater's located in is to bring air in from another location, and or to direct the cool dry air to another location, or both. This can easily be done through either louvered doors or ducting, and we'll cover ducting more in depth in another video. But let's take a look at those room air requirements now, taken directly from the use and care manual. Our use and care manual says that if the water heater isn't ducted, then it can be installed in a room larger than 700 cubic feet and no additional ventilation is needed. And before we go any further, we need to address and understand what 700 cubic feet is. In terms that we're more familiar with, 700 cubic feet is equal to a room 7 feet wide, 10 feet deep, with a 10 feet ceiling. That's 700 cubic feet of air, which is actually what we need. 700 cubic feet of air. If we're talking about a room with these dimensions, then we should consider that anything inside of that room, including the water heater itself, will take away from the 700 cubic feet of air that we need. So 700 cubic feet isn't exactly what size room is needed. It's how much air needs to be inside of whatever size room that the water heater is located in. So, interpreting what the use and care says, if the water heater is installed in a room that contains a minimum of 700 cubic feet of air, then no additional ventilation is needed. If this water heater is installed in a room that has less than 700 cubic feet of air, then there either needs to be a fully louvered door or a door with an upper and lower louvers. This will allow access to the air in the adjacent room. Again, if this water heater is installed in a room with less than 700 cubic feet of air, but the room has a partially louvered door, a couple of other requirements need to be met. First, we need another opening of at least 18 square inches, and we can get that by creating a 3/4 inch gap under the door. Most doors are going to be at least 24 inches wide, and 3/4 of 24 is 18, so that'll get us that minimum of 18 square inches. And secondly, the louver needs to be at the same height as the exhaust air from the heat pump, and that airflow needs to be directed towards the louver. The outlet also needs to be no more than 12 inches away from the louver. Now, if either the inlet or the outlet is ducted, then we can get away with any size room provided that there's that 3/4 inch gap at the bottom of the door. Of course, if both the inlet air and outlet air are ducted, then any size room is okay, and no additional ventilation is needed for the room that the water heater is in. I hope this video has been helpful. Thanks for watching.